I just need to make a slight correction to the signs on the last portion of the lecture. If we are simply talking about the impedance as a function of z, it's a negative sign right here. But as soon as we look at the input impedance, which is what we're measuring for our transmission line, we're really interested in the impedance right here at the input. That's why we're making a transmission line of a specific length. Then when we plug in the minus L here for Z, that gets rid of that negative sign, and that's why we have a positive sign right here. Now let's consider if we want that input impedance to look like a specific inductor, J omega L. Let's suppose that we want this inductor to be 1 nanohenry. And again, let's suppose that this omega is 2 pi, and we're in megahertz. Let's suppose it's 1 megahertz, so 10 to the 6. And we're just going to set this equal. Let's let Z0 be 100 ohms. Maybe it's a 100 ohm transmission line. Our J's are going to cancel out, and we're going to be left with tangent of beta L is going to be equal to omega, which is 2 pi times 10 to the 6, times my inductance, which is 1 times 10 to the minus 9th henries, divided by Z0, which is 100 ohms. So in order to solve for this, I'm just going to take the arctangent of this value, and then if I want the length, not beta L, I'm going to take and let's suppose I want to find it in wavelengths. So I need to divide by beta, which is going to be wavelength divided by 2 pi times the arctangent of 2 pi times 10 to the 6, 1 times 10 to the minus 9 over 100 ohms. And that would give me the length in wavelengths. Now what if I didn't want the length in wavelength? What if I wanted in meters instead? Well, let's suppose that I found that L was equal to a specific number of wavelengths. Then what I would do if I wanted in meters is I would so L in meters is going to be L in wavelengths times however many meters per wavelength I have. Now let's move on to talk about how we actually build these things. Let's suppose that I want to use a short-circuited stub. Let's consider what that means. If I have a coaxial line, there's my shield, and here's my inner conductor, a short circuit simply means that I have connected these together. Most typically, we'll use a connector that has a flat piece of metal right here, which effectively short-circuits the inner conductor to the outer conductor. If I wanted to consider an open-circuited transmission line, then I literally would just leave it open like that. But what if I were building this out of microstrip instead? Let's consider a piece of microstrip. Here's the ground plane underneath. Here's a bit of sandwich material, maybe plastic or glass, something like that. And on top of that, I'm going to draw a microstrip. So that's like the circuit board trace that you might see. If we look at it on the end, here's the piece of metal on the bottom, here's the sandwich material, and then here's this trace right there. In that case, if I want to short circuit it, it means that I have to connect this metal trace to the ground. Typically, we drill a hole and we either through-hole plate it or we solder a piece of metal down through the hole between the microstrip line on the top and the conductor on the bottom. If it's open circuited, we do the same thing that we do in the case of a coaxial line. We just cut off the end and leave it sitting there. We're going to be using these open and short-circuited stubs in some very particular ways. So let's consider what would happen if I had a transmission line and I connected a stub in parallel, like my short-circuited stub right here. And let's suppose that this short-circuited stub has a length such that its input impedance is inductive. In that case, the model that I get is a transmission line with an inductor in parallel. But what if I had connected it this way instead? Same stub, same input impedance, then I would end up with a series inductor. So we can build series inductors, series capacitors, parallel inductors, parallel capacitors, all with a combination of open or short-circuited stubs.